Western Avenue. My name is Eric Ahamada. Today we bring you a special edition of Western Weekly News.
And I am Eric Diaz. This episode is all about the Hour of Code.
We begin with Bethany Max live at the kindergarten yard.
Hi, I am Bethany Max live at the kindergarten center, and I am about to enter Ms. Brown's classroom to introduce some kids.
We code so that to teach our students how to problem solve. So we're teaching them problem solving.
And I think it's really important for kids to learn coding because we're teaching them that skill of persevering. We're trying to teach them, you know, to keep on going even though, you know, sometimes some of the problems seem hard. We want to teach them to persevere through those kinds of things.
Well, the students are learning how different games and things that they use, all the things that programmers do in computer science to make all the games that they love to use work, and it teaches them directionality, how to follow directions, step-by-step rules, and it's just really a lot of critical thinking. It really has to make you stop and think that, wow, this is what we do. We're having all this fun. It takes all this work to make my fun happen. So, what do you think?
Okay.
So, why do we use coding?
We use coding to prepare our students to compete in a worldwide environment, and it's also preparing our students to do computer science, which is what is needed in order to survive in a more competitive world. And with these students, they're especially kids, but we think with this experience, they will be able to have an edge, you know, competing out there.
Why do you think that we should use code?
Coding is, of course, fun. And coding is a new science. And the students should learn how to program their own computer programs. And it's very creative.
On Monday, our school kicked off the Hour of Code with a morning assembly. Here's what happened.
Coding is fun!
Coding is fun!
Coding is fun!
Coding is fun for everyone!
Coding is fun for everyone!
The more you know, the better you know!
The more you come, the better you grow!
So go!
What about it?
It's fun.
What do you call that?
I call it fun.
You are what? What are you doing?
We are directing the Angry Bird to go to the pizza.
And what is that called?
It's called...
What is this hour called? What are we doing at this hour?
Of code.
Hour of code. Okay.
I am doing Hour of Code.
What is Hour of Code?
Hour of Code is a program.
Okay, can you show me how to perform that puzzle? What would you do next?
Nope. Sing a song. I don't know where I'm at.
Try it. What do you think? Read the direction.
Only four?
Okay, it looks like
like most of us are getting on now, which is a good thing.
Tell me about what you're doing right now.
I'm playing Hour of Code.
What is the Hour of Code?
It's a game to help you learn things.
What kind of things are you learning right now?
Like how to do a maze. I'm playing the Angry Birds maze right now.
Oh, so you're helping the bird move from one place to another? Good. So can you show me how to do one? Okay.
All you need to do is just drag these over here.
Okay. And then, so what do you do now?
And then after you put that, it says how many blocks you have to put, and then you put run.
So what do you think you have to do?
Then I would have to change them.
Okay.
I'm working on code.
Emily's interviewing third and fourth grade classes. Let's take a look.
Hi, I'm Emily Hip, live here at third grade building, room 42, Ms. Osby's class, so I can interview them about what they're doing for the Hour of Code.
Tell me, how would you describe code as something that will help kids learn?
Code is an excellent program that helps kids learn because they get to use the internet, they get to use modern technology, it's the 21st century, and this is where the kids are going to be going. So I think that it's really good because it helps them organize directionality and critical thinking skills, and it also helps them to stay focused on the task at hand with the bird and the Angry Bird to do what it's supposed to do. So I think it's an excellent program, and kids are going to be doing this the way of the future. They're going to have awesome jobs just from taking the Hour of Code.
So, Heaven, what are you doing right now?
Playing Hour of Code.
Okay, and I have one question for you. How do you think the Hour of Code is going to help you learn?
It's going to help me learn because you're learning how to code and you're playing games at the same time you're learning.
Okay, thank you.
I like code because it helps me learn, and then it shows you math and language, and
can you tell me, when will you guys be doing code?
We'll be doing code. We usually do code like after lunch.
Next, we have Hilda with Miss Rundle. Let's see what they're doing about the Hour of Code.
We use coding so that students can learn how to speak computer language so that students can get great computer jobs in the future. Thank you.
What are some ways to move the Angry Bird?
Forward, left, and right.
What are some ways to move the Angry Bird?
Prepare the kids to prepare the students for future jobs in computer science.
Here's a clip of our teachers learning how to code with code.org.
Down came the good fairy and she said,
I don't want to see you.
about tips to solve puzzles?
I worked with a partner.
Collaborate.
Yes, so beads, different colors. So the black ones or the purple ones will represent these, and the clear, the ones without the color will represent the white ones.
But I want you to look at the page, and I want you to find the first letter of your name, and you're going to fill in the bracelet on the bottom of the squares. So if it starts with a black square, you're going to shade it in with your pencil or pen. If it's white, you can just leave it blank.
I'm not really good with lyrics.
Oh, see, perfect. So this is the perfect lesson for you to learn function.
Thank you.
Okay, easy one.
Now to a report from Giovanni Flores with Ms. Sanchez and Ms. Bagby.
My name is Giovanni Flores and I'm here live in Ms. Sanchez's room where they are doing Hour of Code. I'm going to be interviewing some students. Why do you think coding is very challenging?
I think coding is very challenging because it gives you different levels that are like higher than like not the normal code.
Okay. How do you think Hour of Code helps your children in class?
It actually helps my students to keep trying. A lot of the mazes I noticed that are somehow complicated for them. But what I like is that they're able to work with one another. If I see that one of the students is able to pass a maze, another student helps them. So it helps them in knowing learning how to work with one another. And it helps them in their cognitive thinking and their persistence of making sure that they keep trying to pass a level that they're having a trouble with. So it's persistence. I really like it. And the kids seem to enjoy it as well.
How is coding very challenging?
Because you have to work hard.
Do you think coding is very challenging to the students?
Yes, I do.
How do you think coding helps your students in class?
I think it helps them to develop perseverance in solving problems.
Do you think coding is very hard?
Sometimes it can be, sometimes it can't. Because sometimes you just have to go forward, or you have to just turn and do forward.
Exactly. How do you think coding helps your students in class?
Well, it's critical thinking. They have to think about where the angry bird is moving and how to feed the pig. So they have to actually use critical thinking skills about the movements, about where to turn and how to turn. So it helps them to problem solve.
And now our very own Mr. Kagiwa will tell us more about coding. How do teachers sign up for your coding workshop?
Teachers can sign up for the coding workshops by going onto the code.org websites, and they will find the workshop that I offer here at Western Avenue. Mostly it's in the library. I have held about 4 workshops already and they've been very successful. I will be having 1 workshop each month starting January 2015. So if you want to know more about coding and get free supplies from code.org, such as goodie bags, puzzles, and all these other cool stuffs, please go to code.org website and look for professional development for K-5 teachers, and make sure you find Western Avenue Elementary School workshop hosted by me.
Thank you for watching our special edition of Western Weekly News. My name is Erica Almada.
And I am Eric Diaz, and
we are Western.